the world today as we live in, we have to deal with what's going on globally. As I go to the pyramid to Egypt this morning, on this Sunday morning, going into July the 3rd, we have to talk about the 7th and the 3. And as we get ready to deal with what's going on in the world, it's a scripture, Proverb 3:6, in all thy ways acknowledge God, he will direct your paths. So we got to look at what's going on globally and what's going on around the universe and what's happening with what's going on. So some of the things that's going on here in America and what's going on around the world is the people have changed, and we are in a vacuum. This morning, as we look at the pyramids, we look at ancient Egypt, where all knowledge and wisdom come from, and where we are right now finding out that we are the rulers of the universe. We are the builders of the universe. We are the makers of the universe. And we are the gods that built the pyramids, that build the Incas, that build America, that build all over the world. We are the people. Solomon, King Solomon, Moses, David, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, those was black people. And I can show you in scripture what it was, black people. So we have to understand where we come from and how we've been fooled and tricked and bamboozled to the point that we are nothing. The Jews, the real Jews, they are black, out of Africa, Ethiopia. The Ark of the Covenant was given by God, and it was built by a black man. So these are the questions that we have to deal with going into 2016, 2017, to rise up out of the ashes and understand the pyramids, which is our marker that we are the beginning of life. And once we understand that, we move to the next level of growth. So it's very important to understand who you are, where you are, and where you should be going. So it's important to understand that God have a special place for us, and God is moving us into another level of education, another level of learning. So it's important to understand your prayer request is important. Your request to work with people is important. 2016, 2017, bringing on a world order of new people handed down by God. And if I give you that information, I'm talking about there's new people, new things, new art, new history being found. When you find out that Moses was a black man, do it frighten you? You find out that Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob was black? It shouldn't. It's history, and you should know your history. You should know who built the pyramid of Giza. You need to know Moses met with the pharaohs, and he was black and they was black. So they talked to each other. So it's very important in this morning, going into the 4th of July, 2016, to understand you must stand up, stop the killing, save the baby, and begin to understand who you are. You are a world traveler. You are people that have built the pyramid, that built the Empire State Building, that built Washington, D.C., that built all over the world, that farmed the land, tilled the soil. We are the people, our ancestry, our great ancestry have did that. And let's go back, and our ancestry still moving around us today. Psalms 119, and I want you to read Proverbs 8:6, Proverbs 3:6, Matthew 6:33, seek first the kingdom of God and all the right. I want to let you know that you're looking for a God outside of you, and the God energy is in you. You're looking for a pie in the sky, and you the pie. So it's important as we stand today, as we look in 2016, 2017, there will be changes, but God made man and woman to recreate, to procreate. So God said Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve. So all the other stuff is crazy people. People that are out of their mind, feel like they can overpower the universe. You cannot overpower God, because God is God. And I told you Romans 1 and 26, God turned over to a reprobate mind. Leviticus 18 and 22, God said a man shouldn't lay with animals, or a man with a man, or woman with woman. This is the law of God. When you look at the Ten Commandments that was gave to Moses, when you look at the Ten Commandments that was given to Moses by the ancestors, who know the Book of the Dead, and the book, the Egyptian Book of the Dead, speak of life, and speak of life controlling. So get ready for life, and get ready for things to move quick, fast, and in a hurry. So I feel that you should understand where we at, what we should be, and we move it into the period of recreation, the period of law. No justice, no peace, the universal law of God. And when you do the universal law of God, you get a breakthrough when you do the universal the law of God. So we're doing the universal law of God to break things down. So the ancient pyramid was built by the black man. And anything in America that built the black man mind, the mind of God, we are the gods of the universe. We are the gods of the world. So I want you to know, if you're a woman, you're the queen of the world. You're the goddess of the world. I want you to begin to move in 2016 like you the God of the world. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son. Who he give? You and me. God wrapped yourself in flesh and come down to speak to the issues of man, which he made man, and he made man because he wanted man to carry on. So this morning, wherever you're doing, wherever you might be, you're barbecuing, doing all the 4th of July stuff, but you got to understand, God is in control. Let me say it again. God is in control. You in control. It's some things that made you go crazy. It's some things that messed with your speeches. It's some things that messed with your family. But as I be the prophet today, all this week, I want you to call me. I want to give you what you know. Blog Talk Radio, and we're on Blog Talk Radio 7 days a week, Sundays from 11 to 12, Mondays night from 11 to 12, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, all the week, we're on Blog Talk Radio, and we're talking about Dr. Martin Luther King movement and the movement. Then we're also talking about crossing with the ancestor. Tonight, we're talking about the ancestor this morning. This evening, we're talking about the ancestor. Yes, your ancestor is still around you. The angels was black. I hate to bring this up, but I want our children to know that we have history. And our history go deeper than Martin Luther King, than Malcolm X, than Robeson or Harriet. It go deeper than Martin Garvey. Our history go back to the ancient Egypt, go back to Kemet. It go back way back. So we do have history. We do have power. So we have to deal with the power of God in us. We black, we proud. And somebody tried to stop that. Somebody tried to tell us that we was nothing. Somebody tried to put us on dope and drugs and kept us from our true heritage. But from the ankles of the pyramid, the ancient Egypt, and the gods from the universe made the pyramid. out of a mind that is created by the Almighty God. Yes, you are a queen. Yes, you are a king. Yes, you are a God. So you should act like a God and move everything negative away from you and call the thing positive. And I want you to know, when you hold that ankh up, that means life. Life flow from the womb. Life flow from the now. Life flow from God. Get ready this morning for the next level. Whatever you're doing, yes, you can make it. Doors open up for you. I want you to get ready. And I want you to get ready for the universal God. I want you to create that God that's in you, that energy that's in you. Yes. You can master every negativity that the devil put out in, every dark energy, every energy of magic or witchcraft. You can master because you are the man of God. You are the woman of God. God created you in his image and his likeness. So you're the image of God because you are a God. So you have to speak all is well. You have to speak that I'm healed. You got to speak I'm delivered. I want you to know this morning, you can speak some things and they'll go away. I want you to know this morning, east, west, north, and south, you can speak the storm. You can speak the storm. You can speak the flood. You can speak to those things. They're not and they become true. I'm praying for you, you and you. This is Bishop, the prophet of Isaac, the prophet of Jacob, the prophet of all the prophets of old, come to witness to you that all is well. As you look on this pyramid, it's power. I'm giving you power. Let me pray. Father God, the God of Abraham, the God of Jacob, your God and my God, the power of God. Every woman that look at this pyramid, let her become pure. Every man that look at this pyramid, let his mind become pure. Uncross him. Break spells and curses right now. In the mighty name of the Almighty God, we give power to the Holy Ghost. We give power east, west, north, and south. All the ancient people that come back to help and deliver the Native Americans, those that have been walking in the name of the Father, Son, and Spirit. God bless you. I see something happening for you, Rose. I'm praying for you especially. I want to tell you, Rose, things gonna work out for you. And I want to tell you, as I walk the mountain, as I go up higher in the mountain here in South Dakota, as I go further around the water, I see God revealing some things to you. I want you to know all is well, Brother Burns, there in Chicago. I want to pray for you down in Monroe, Louisiana. And I want you to know Sue Holland, I'm praying for you. I want to tell you, Tina Holland, I'm praying for you. Mary Hawkins in Detroit, I'm praying for you. I'm praying for Bessie up in Denver. I want you to know there's no sorrow on earth that heaven cannot heal. Whatever you're going through, I want you to stand up and say, God be the glory, God be the strength, and God will make it work for you. Whatever's going on in your life right now, I see God open up a door for you. Don't forget, every Friday, I will be at the Hilton at Chicago, Illinois. That's 95th and Cicero. I will be there from 4 to 9, the blessing hour. I'm telling you that I will be blessing every Friday. I want you to be there, Pearl. I want you to be there, Regina. I want you to be there, Prophet Lena. I want you to be there. I said, let me say it again. I will be at the Hilton Hotel in Chicago, Cicero and 95th, Friday, this Friday, from 4 to 9. I will be blessing for 2016 and giving prophecy out. All you need to do is get there. God will do the rest. I said, 95th and Cicero, I will be there in Chicago. I will be back in Chicago. And I want you to be there, Tina. I want you, Angela, to be there. I want you, Tina, to be there. Nita, I want you to be there. I want you to come for God to bless you. God got a blessing that he said he's going to give you. God going to put a door for you. I want you to go knowing, sowing, and flowing in the right direction. Get ready for God to bless you on this first Sunday. and it's first Sunday in July. All is well, east, west, north, and south. I'm praying mightily for you. I'm praying that every door that closed will be opened up. I'm praying that God will break the yoke for you. That yoke that's been closed, God gonna open it up for you. I know on this holiday going into 4th of July that God got a blessing for you. We're praying for every family that lost somebody, those that lost them in the army, in the war, or whatever. We're praying that God will open up that door and let your mind open up. God is able to do anything but fail. I'm praying for the families that's going through some things right now. I'm praying for the young man that caught up on the drugs and seemed like that he can't make it. But I want you to know God is able to let you make it. As I get ready, Matthew 6 and 33 says, seek first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. I want you to seek out for God. Walk in the God's way. Walk that way. Every door that closed will be opened up. I'm praying for your healing this morning, wherever you might be. I'm praying for those that lost people over in Bangladesh, that lost people over in Turkey. The violence just keep on, but we have to keep on praying because we have to defeat the enemy. We have to defeat Satan and his war. It's the spiritual warfare going on in the world. Your request, your prayer request, in all thy ways acknowledge God, he will direct your path. In the spirit of Prophet L.K. Johnson today, Psalms 119, he will direct your path, and your pathway will be open for you. So get ready for God to bless you this morning. Get ready to walk in the anointing of God. Get ready to walk where God can bless you east, west, north, and south. Those that looking for a blessing, as we go to Egypt, as we go over to Africa, as we go around the world today, we're asking for you and you. It's good to know Jesus. It's good to know where you come from. Good to know where you're going. Every door that closed will be open for you. Every person that put you down, God will lift you up. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And David was saying, the Lord is my, it was many gods, but David said, the Lord is my shepherd. There, David know, and he was a black man, David know who he was. He know who he was honoring. So it was so many different gods back in that day, but David said, the Lord is my shepherd that I shall not want. My shepherd. I want you to know that you got to know that God directs you this morning, this evening, wherever it is. God directs you. Let go and let God and be healed and delivered. Right now is the time for you to walk in the anointing of the Holy Ghost. It's time for you to claim your healing. I claim it. I claim it. I claim it for you. I claim your deliverance. I claim your healing. I claim your peace. I claim your joy. I claim it for you now. If you can't claim it, I want to claim it for you this morning. And I want you to know, at the 11 o'clock hour every Sunday, we're on Blog Talk Radio every Sunday from 11 to 12. And this broadcast is Sunday morning with the Sunday morning seminar with Bishop Turner. This seminar is to talk from 11 to 12. It's to give you a head up on what's going on around the world, what's happening, where you might be able to speak to issues that God speak to. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Right now, I'm praying for somebody that's listening to me for your chest. I'm praying for somebody that got to go to surgery, and that surgery is going to be all right. I'm praying for you, Sister Martha, that things will be all right. I'm praying that every door that's closed will be open. And I want to let you know today, as we get ready to go to the next level, God have already chosen you to be special. Get ready for the $1 trillion flow. Get ready for the breakthrough. Get ready for your financial breakthrough. I want to claim your new home for you in Jesus' name. I want to claim your new car in Jesus' name. I want to break yoke for you in Jesus' name. I want you to get ready in Jesus' name to claim things that's happening for you in Jesus' name. Peace and love. Peace and love, brother.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, I'm on the radio right now. I'm doing my blog talk.
And it's early, it's 10
now, I'm on my YouTube. And God is doing that for you. I want you to get ready. As I get ready to open up that door for you, that every door that closed will be open. So I want you to get ready this morning to claim it. Claim your breakthrough. Claim your healing. Claim your deliverance. As we get ready to do this, those that are listening, I'm praying for somebody cataracts tonight, somebody in cataract, somebody in their knees, I'm praying. I'm looking around floods that's around Kansas City that's coming. I see around Missouri that's a lot of storms coming in the month of July. And we're going into that month of heat in Illinois. We'll be doing that. Now, as we get ready to do our ceremony this morning, and we do it with the Native American, thank you, Chief Izzy. Thank you, Sister Carrie. And we also thank you that come. Longfoot and Lightfeather, thank you, that come to pray with us today as we get ready to pray. So it's important for us to pray that prayer of faith. It's important for us to take down. So as we go on air, y'all have to kind of be quiet as we get ready to do this. Okay. God bless you this morning. How are you? Okay.
Okay.
It's good to know Jesus. Jesus. He's really at a valley. Say that, say that. A resting place. Say that. Jesus. Say that, say that. it up. Amen.
My son.
Amen.
Seven.
Say that. Falling in love with Jesus. And I want to say that the seven ones that come in. I want to say to you, we have to go back to the old landmark. We got to go back to where we come from. I want you to be blessed. I want you to go knowing, sowing, and flowing in the right direction. I want you to know that God got a blessing for you. As I go into the elements, as I go to the top of the mountain, as I go to the water, God is speaking in his water, wind, fire, and earth. God is speaking to you, man. God is speaking to you, family. God is trying to open up a door for you. God bless you on this first Sunday. I want you to know that God is in control. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Get ready for a breakthrough in this month. Get ready for July to be the month that you be happy, the month that you be healed, the month you be delivered. Get ready for a breakthrough in your body, in your mind, in your soul. I decree this morning God's going to work out it for you. God's going to work them doors open up for you, the job you need, the healing that you need, the breakthrough that you need. Oh, I just see God doing it for you. I'm praying much for you, Rose. I'm praying much for you, Barbara Ann. And I'm praying much for you, Alberta. All is well. I want you to know, Nita, every door that's been closed, God gonna open up. And I want to prophesy this. This is the month for you to look for your car, and next month is for you to drive it. I want you to get ready for God to bless you, east, west, north, and south. I want you to get ready for God to pour his blessing out on you this morning. As I travel to the pyramid, as I travel to Egypt, as I travel around the world, I can see God working his work. God is speaking to us. God is telling us all is well. And everything is in divine order. I want you to say that. God is too intelligent to make a mistake. Man made the mistake. God is in control. And if God is in control, you just need to connect with God. For God so loved the world, he sent his only begotten son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Get ready this morning for God to bless you. Get ready to say, the Lord, heal me. Open up a door for me. Sometimes we need to decree all is well. We need to say, God is working in my behalf. We got to say, the seed has been planted in prayer. Sometimes you got to pray, but you got to put a shot on it. Say, here come my miracle. Here come my breakthrough. Here comes my deliverance. I want you to know this morning, your deliverance is a moment away. Your breakthrough is a moment away. I want you to hold on. Don't let go, because God got your back. I'm praying for you, Sister Barbara. God bless you. Betty in Texas, I'm praying for you and your husband. All is well. Brother Bronze, I'm praying for you. I want you to know that God got a door open up for you. And I want you to know God can do anything but fail. God bless you. I want to tell the Hawking family, I'm praying for you. Y'all went through that death. There's no sorrow on earth that heaven cannot heal. And I want to tell Sister Pearl, hang on in there. Things going to be all right. And I want to tell Sister Mary, hang on in there. Every door closed will open up. As I visit on Tuesday and Thursday, sometime I go in the spirit realm, and I give prophecy, and I want to let you know, this month, I will be over at the Hilton. That's at 95th and Cicero. What you're going to be doing, Bishop, I'm going to be prophesying and giving you a blessing for this month and next month. Before this month out, I will be in Detroit. And after this month, I will be up in St. Paul, Minnesota. So God is moving us around in order to do some things. So I want you to just get ready for God to bless you this morning. I want you to get ready to claim your deliverance and claim your healing. I want you to get ready to claim what God got for you. See, the prodigal son had to make up his mind, I need to go out in the world. But the Hebrew boys had to make up their mind that they're going to stick with God. You got to make up your mind this morning, all is well. East, west, north, and south. You got to say, Bishop told me all is well, and I'm going to claim it because God said the wages of sin is death. The gift of God eternal. I want to tell you this morning, I don't care what's going on around you, God got your back. I want to let you know God will open every door for you. And as God opens that door, it's going to be a blessing. As I climbed the mountain, I told you over in Egypt where divine life come from. I told you down the Nile and up on the pyramid. When you look at the pyramid, you're going to see yourself. You can see the energy of your ancestor. You can see the energy of your great-great-grandma, your great-grand. You, when you look at the White House, when you look at America, it's built by ancestry. So they came over and they came over in chains and they were hung on the tree, but they still survived. God have opened up a door for me and you. Don't let your kids get the synthetic drug that they're putting out there is nothing but the work of the devil. I think the name of it is alligator. It eats you up. So you got the young folks got to know, Mama, how you know about alligator? Alligator is a drug that come from the pits of hell and the devil feeding it to our youth in the college. It's made up in the laboratory. I want you to get ready for God to bless you. I got one word for you this morning. All is well. Sometimes you need to say that when you think you're down. You got to say, all is well. I see a brighter day. I see things open up. I'm praying for you, Sister Robin, Sister Pat. I'm praying for you. Sister Dorothy, I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you right now, Sister William. I'm praying for you. Ophelia, I'm praying for you. Louise, I'm praying for you. I want you to know all is well, Pearl. God going to get you at the next level. And I want you to know that going through a death, there's no sorrow on earth that heaven cannot heal. The heaven is healing your sorrow. Let go and let God this morning. What's your problem here? You got to fall back in love with God. You done tore loose from God. You're working with the devil. But you got to work with God this morning. If God be the glory, God be, I don't care who get married, how many men get married to men, how many women get married to women, but God is in control. Somebody told a lie. Somebody told a lie. Somebody say it's all right, but somebody lied. But the Bible said Adam and Eve, somebody lying to somebody. Who lying to who? Wake up. Who been lying to you? Tell you it's all right. Somebody's lying to you this morning. In all their ways, acknowledge God. He will direct your paths. Proverbs 3:6. In all their ways, acknowledge God. He will direct your path. What that mean? That means you got to pray. You got to ask God for you jump into things. You said, God be the glory. God be the glory. Yes, I'm praying for you, Mickey. God said, you coming back this way, the devil tried to give you a black eye, but I want you to rise up. Your mind is cleared up. Your body, prayer, change. I just need some people this morning that want to pray. So, Bishop, I feel like shouting. I feel like praying. I feel like that God's going to move quick, fast, and in her. Whatever you've been going through, I'm praying for the people out in California and Berkeley that went through the fire. I'm praying for them down in West Virginia that went through the flood. You've been through the flood. You've been through the fire. But God still kept you. And I want you to hold your head up. You might not have nothing, but God going to give you something. I want you to hold your head up. I want you to understand that God going to give you a blessing. God going to do it for you. God going to give you some new stuff. Let go and let God. God going to bless you quick, fast, and in a hurry. Get ready and claim your healing. Claim your blessing tonight. Claim that God will open up every door that's been closed. I just see God praying for you, Roberta. I see God doing something for you, Gina. I see God breaking the door up for you, Ruth. Ruth, you call. I told you all is well. I want you to get ready, Natalie. God got something for you. I see God this morning healing somebody in the side. I see somebody being healed in their heart. I decree healing for you. I'm getting revelation knowledge. Somebody got to go to surgery, but I want the word to say it's going to be all right. I want to let you know as I get revelation knowledge, you've been kind of sick. I want you to drink more water. I want you to drink more water because the Spirit said water will heal your body. I want you to get ready for a breakthrough this month. I want this month to be the month where you can testify that God did everything for you. I want you to testify this morning that this God did more for you in the month of July, because this is your month to break through. This is your month for healing. This is your month for deliverance. This is your month to talk to God. This is the month for you to make recommend with God and say, for God be the glory, for God be the strength. I want you to get ready this morning. God bless you and you this morning. We're going around the world as we travel, as God show us things. I'm praying for you, Sister Minnie, right down in Lexington, Mississippi. And I'm praying for you, Sister Ross, for God to bless you. Down in Baton Rouge, Big Prophet Ben Ross and his family, I'm praying for him. And I'm praying for you and you. Everybody need prayer, and prayer need to come with you. This is the month of your blessing. Proverbs, if you just read chapter 3, verse 6. In all thy ways acknowledge God, he will direct your path. I'm glad that David obeyed God. I'm glad that the Hebrew boys obeyed God. I'm glad that Samson obeyed God. You got to obey God to get what you want this morning. You have not because you ask not. Get ready for God to bless you. Oh, I wish I had somebody who wanted to get the blessing. God want to bless you this morning. I want to pray for that cataract that I've been burning. I want to pray for that throat. I want right now. I'm asking for healing from the Almighty God. God cut you. I want you to know, east, west, north, and south, there's storms, there's floods, there's tornadoes, that earthquake. I prophesied about two planes running together. I prophesied about two trains on the same track. Something wrong with that. You got a Greyhound bus ticket and you out at the airport. You got an airport ticket and you at the Greyhound bus station. Something wrong with you. I'm telling you, the devil come to kill and destroy, but the word of God will deliver you, glory, hallelujah. The word of God will heal you. You ain't gonna pray with me, but God will do something for you this morning. God can heal you right now. God can bring your son out. I told you we ought to see the Abraham blessed and highly favored. God told Abraham, I'm gonna bless your seed, and I'm gonna make you the father of many nations. I'm walking in the blessing of Abraham. I'm walking in the anointing of my ancestors. You are walking in the anointing of Abraham, Jacob. You're walking in the anointing of the prophets and the angels of God. You blessed and highly favored this morning. Stop crying. Hold you. Stop fussing. Say all is well, because God going to give you what you want. God going to give you what you need. But you got to let go of sin. You got to let go of lust. You got to let go of jealousy and let God in. If you can't let God in, ain't no light. You got to let the light. You got to let the light of God come in your mind. You got to let the light of God touch your heart. When you the light of God touch your heart, he heal body, mind, soul, and spirit. Right now, the alcohol got to go. The drugs got to go. The high blood. blood sugar tumors got to go. Cancer got to go. Cataracts got to go. In the name of Jesus, we curse it and come out. In the name of Jesus, this is the first Sunday. You got to call it out. I'm healed. I'm in divine order. Whatever you're going through, let go and let God. In all thy ways, acknowledge God. On your way to school, acknowledge God. On your way to work, acknowledge God. Driving along the highway, acknowledge God. At home, acknowledge God. Working in your garden, wherever you're at, people, just acknowledge God and the devil will flee. The devil come to kill and destroy. He's a liar. He's a deceiver. But if you acknowledge God, Pearl, God's going to give you the glory. What all the devil stole, God's going to give back to you this morning. What all the devil pushed out, God's going to give it back to you. God want to give it back to you now. You got to claim it. You got to claim that all is well. You got to speak the language, all is well. You got to speak the language that God will heal you. You got to speak the language this morning, all is well. When you begin to speak that language, see, the good thing about the Hebrew boys, they said, we're not going to bow to you, King, because our God is God. We're not going to bow. And they didn't bow. When they walked into the fire furnace, there was God sitting there in the air condition. I want to tell you this morning, when the prodigal son time ready to go, his father gave him what fell to him and he left. I want you to know this morning, God got a blessing with your name on it. And what you got to do, get some praise to what you want. Your miracle, your breakthrough, it's a moment away. I want you to claim it this morning. I want you to know that all is well. I want you to know this morning, I see God opening a door for you. I see God doing something for you. And God finna open up that door that been closed to you. And God finna do something special. You know, when you read Psalms 119, I want to thank Prophet Tina that read it last week. And it was a breakthrough. People called in and said that scripture helped me. I couldn't go to sleep. After she read it, I could rest. I want to tell you this morning that God finna open up a door for you. I want you to get ready this morning for this month to be a month of success. I'm praying for you, Bessie. I'm praying for you right now. Sherry, I'm praying for you. And I want to tell you, Diane in Atlanta, Georgia, thank you for the call. I'm praying for you also. Rita, I'm praying for you. Every letter, every telephone call, every expression of love, I want you to know that God got you. As I prophesied this morning, this first Sunday, I see God got a blessing for you. 50-50, God told me to tell you to read Psalms 98. That's going to be a blessing for you. I want you to get ready for God to open up that door that been closed for you. 81-38, I want you to get ready. Psalms 13 and Psalms 12, I want you to get ready because the 59 number Psalm going to work for you. As I go to the next level, and I told you, when you go to YouTube, go to Bishop Turner Sunday morning seminar with the bishop. As you go to YouTube, and you'll see the pyramid. And if you look at that pyramid, I want you to go to YouTube. The blessing is in the pyramid this month. I want you to look at it. And when you look at it, I want you to read Psalms 123. But don't read Psalms until you look at the pyramid. I want you to look at it for 5 minutes. It's on YouTube. When you go to YouTube, you go to Bishop Turner. The blessing, your financial blessing, your house, your car, whatever you want, is in that pyramid. Because in that pyramid, I see ancient Egypt. I see the saints of God. I see in that pyramid, I see our ancestors who built the pyramid in Giza. I see our ancestors who built New York, Chicago, Mississippi. Our ancestors farmed in Mississippi, farmed in Alabama, farmed in Georgia. Our people built the desert. Our people with the California and set the irrigation where they can have water in Los Angeles. Our people did the pipeline. Get ready for the blessing. Get ready to know who you are. I want to tell you, this month is a month that God going to change your life. This is the month for you to walk away from that alcohol addiction, that drug addiction, walk away from that cocaine, crack, and that new and fitted drugs called alligator. You can walk away from alligator, and you can walk away from baboon. You have some baboon drugs. And you know, the Spirit just gave me that. It's a baboon drug. You get the drug, you act like a baboon. You get the alligator drug, and it'll make it eat your body up because you call it alligator. I want to tell Dr. Griggs, you ain't heard about the baboon drug. The baboon drug make you act crazy. So this is all made up in a laboratory. They all made by the scientists of evil. They all made by the devil. You got to ask God to take back all that the devil have stole. The devil is a deceiver. He's a liar. And he will keep you down. He will keep you depressed. He will make you miss suicide. But in the name of Jesus, you heal. In the name of Jesus, you deliver. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, this morning, I want to send out the angel Raphael, the healing angel, to your home, wherever you might be. I want Archangel Michael to go forth with Versiel to fight your battle. It ain't your battle, it's God's battle. If you just say, Jesus, touch me, it ain't your fight. It's God's fight. I want you to get ready and let God do something for you. I want you to get ready to let God, let this month be a month that you stop lying, you stop cursing. Get to be, once you get the Holy Ghost, you got a new tongue, your new talk, a new walk, a new shout. Get ready for your new miracle. You got to claim. You ask not, you have to ask God what you want this morning. Lord, I want to be healed. Lord, I want to be delivered. I want a breakthrough. Quick, fast, and in a hurry. And God's going to do it for you. Somebody know what I'm talking about. God's going to do it for you. He's going to do it quick, fast, and in a hurry for you. So you ought to be claiming what you want God to do for you. Stop playing with God. See, they playing with God when they talk about two men going to get married, they're playing with God. About two women going to get married, they're playing with God. The wage of sin is death to give God. See, God is finna get ready to turn this stuff around. This ain't your fight, this God fight. I gave you the scriptures, you can read it. Leviticus 18 and 22, Romans 1 and 26, God turned over the rubber man. And I want to let you know, somebody's lying. Somebody's lying. The Bible is the book of knowledge and wisdom. It's the word of God. If you don't take the word of God real, I know you don't take nothing else. The wage of sin is death, the gift of God eternal life. I want you to get ready for God to bless you today. I want you to get ready for a door to open up for you. Yes, get ready. I want you to get ready for God to bless you. Get ready for God to open that door for you. You've been going through something. You've been sick for a minute. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the saints of God. Hallelujah to the prophets of God. Hallelujah to God in the highest. Hallelujah. In the east, in the west, in the south. God, loose our people out of bondage. Loose our people out of sin. God is the source of our survival. Without prayer, you're dead in the water. Take a fish out the water, you die. Take a man from God, he die. So I want you to get back with God. All things are pot for those that believe. I believe this month is your month to be healed and delivered. This month is the month for your finance to come up. This is the month that I push that cancer, that cataract, that tumor, that high blood away from you in the name of Jesus. The blood, you're covered under the blood of Jesus. You're covered under the ancestor blood. You're covered under the saints of God. God bless you this morning. I want to go to Detroit. I want Dr. Christian to pray the prayer of faith. On this first Sunday, I know God done gave her a song. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. I don't want to sing this morning, but I'll break out and sing. Don't you say nothing, Mary. If I break up and sing, they're going to be calling. If I start to say, somebody asked me, bitch, can you sing? Yeah, I can sing. I'm just waiting. We're going to have Dr. Christian to come in our way. God bless you, Dr. Christian, all the way from Detroit. Yes. Amen. Amen. for my good.
Again, he said unto me, prophesy from these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry